a key factor for anyone deciding whether they're going to go to an online environment is this notion of cheating or plagiarism. This program will talk about ways to address it, reduce it, even just identify it. Those things are important, right? For all of you to feel more comfortable with online learning. I think probably 30-40% of people out there would say it's a done deal, closed conversation, if there's a lot of cheating that takes place in a learning, whether it's a face-to-face, a blended, fully online, radio, television. Well, let's look at some ways in which we can reduce plagiarism in online environments. And this show is brought to you from Indiana University in Bloomington. Now, first of all, you need to know what plagiarism is. You need both the instructors, the program managers, as well as students to understand a bit about plagiarism and how to identify it, how to reduce it. You know, the tools that are out there, like Turnitin, that will enable you to, in fact, address plagiarism and hopefully reduce it within your classroom settings. So utilizing tools, knowing what it is, maybe having students take practice tests. Go to an online website that has examples of plagiarism so that students can, in fact, address it personally. They can take a test, take some examples, and see what's happening. There's actually a tutorial from here at Indiana University on what is plagiarism, brought to you by Dr. Ted Frick from my Instructional Systems Technology Department. Take a look at that open short quiz and concept lessons that Dr. Frick has created. Try it out. Go to his plagiarism tutorial. Maybe go to a plagiarism tutorial from the University of Southern Mississippi. See across these two different plagiarism examples what it actually is. Or maybe go to DePaul University, which has a website on deterring plagiarism and cheating. It has a fantastic video clip that will show how plagiarism is being played out within class settings and how to reduce it, how to address it. There's also a website called plagiarize.com, which has dead giveaways. If something's been plagiarized, that website can tell you, in fact, whether or not something's been plagiarized. It has examples of essays and other work of students that will indicate plagiarism. Now, there are techniques to reduce plagiarism that I'm going to talk about here. There are ways to address it. There are problems that are common within an online setting in terms of plagiarisms and instances of cheating. But, you know, there are things that you can do on the front end, just announcing you're going to be on the lookout for it to detect it. Having randomization of items within your test bank. Having student testimonials from prior semesters. Consequences posted from students who, in fact, had cheated in the past as examples. Oftentimes, your best strategies for detecting and dealing with plagiarism come from prior experience. So the first time you teach, you might not have as much as previous. So you might go to online plagiarism portals like this one created by Sharon Sturger. This website has excellent articles related to plagiarism. It has websites that have examples of plagiarism. It has some cheating websites. You can go to them and see what it looks like. You know, there are many challenges that we all face in trying to deal with students who might not even explicitly realize that they're cheating, but in fact that they are. But there are other cases where, in fact, you know that they were intently, purposefully cheating. There's a video in YouTube showing Coke bottles where students take the Coke bottle and wrap around answers on the bottle and bring the Coke bottle into their class in a face-to-face class. There's a dummy that went to Michigan. There's a lot of dummies. No, there aren't that many dummies in Michigan, but there was one dummy in Michigan. They took and got a Social Security number, a fraternity did, took him to class and got him a degree in a face-to-face class. So if you're saying that cheating online is going to be the discussion stopper for you, if students cheat, keep in mind students cheat face-to-face, and you're probably teaching face-to-face, and you're not stopping there. What we need are techniques to reduce it. We're not going to eliminate it, but we can reduce it to a significant degree. So consider Turnitin.com as a tool that you might use in your classes. See if your university, your organization, your institution, your school corporation is using Turnitin. and get some training in how to use it. Red light, green light, yellow light. You know, green is go. It's pretty good stuff. It's not been plagiarized. Yellow, maybe. Red, if a lot of things are flagged red, it has been. Have, of course, some announcements regarding plagiarism and the consequences so students know. Let them know what happened in previous classes of the course. So if you use Turnitin.com, compare notes with other instructors who have. Give it a chance. Put all papers in, or maybe just those suspected of plagiarism. Try plagiarism.org. Take a look at the website, plagiarism.org, by the Turnitin.com people, and they will explain the plagiarism problems that we all face, both in online and face-to-face environments. Eve, or Eve 2, is a plagiarism detection software that you might be able to buy personally if your university doesn't have their own detection software. Or plagiarismdetect.com will also be a software package that you might use in your classes to detect plagiarism. Many websites allow plagiarism. AcademicTermPapers.com, students can buy papers. Take a look at Academic Term Papers or The Cheating House or Spark Notes or OtherPeople'sPapers.com, ResearchPaper.com. You can find term papers and examples at Mega Essays, My Essays, Pink Monkey. You never have to use Cliff Notes again, it says at that website. Free Essay Network. All these free websites are getting people to, in effect, write papers for them in other countries around the world, whether it's the Philippines or someplace in Africa, and they make money on these, and then they sell their papers. Take a look at these websites. The more familiar you are with things like Turnitin.com, the detection software, as well as the plagiarism sites like Academic Term Papers and The Cheating House, you'll be more likely to detect it. Cut and paste in those things suspected of cheating into Google and see if you find it. Oftentimes, if you suspect it, you will find, in fact, that that has been cheating. Time your exams, potentially, so students have a limited time. Maybe you do the opposite and encourage cheating, encourage collaboration, so students talk to their partner at a website, at a computer lab, and they enter individual answers. Maybe have open book exams that are really, really hard. Proctored exams, exams with passwords or security codes. Maybe you consider synchronous testing, so students meet you in a chat and you ask them questions, you know, a different student every week, or sets of students, so they don't know who's going to be tested each week. So darn hard, and the test so hard, nobody in their right mind would want to cheat for them. Allow or disallow retakes. That's your call, your decision in terms of the testing. Get writing samples early in the course. If you get a writing sample early and their writings change later in the course, you know something's amok. You might want to investigate this further. You might want to find out how that student all of a sudden transformed into this brilliant Shakespearean writer. Randomize the items from a computer software test bank, so the sequence of items are different for each student. But these are just some of many ideas related to plagiarism in online environments. There are tons of other things you can do, which include things like the University of Virginia, students taking an oath of that they will not cheat. You know, it could include just at some point fingerprint recognition, iris scanning, and all sorts of handwriting recognitions in the future. But proctored exams seem to be the common way, using Turnitin.com and Eve, having a plagiarism website that shows students, you know, or practice tests that shows them what is plagiarism and what isn't and what is fair. All these things combine together to create a tactic or strategy for identifying, addressing, and reducing plagiarism in your classroom. Hopefully you'll find some methods or techniques that work well for you. There are dozens and dozens of them, and don't let it be the factor that stops you from entering online environments. Change up your exams every semester if that's the concern. Create unique activities and tasks if that's your concern, but address it in proactive as opposed to just reactive ways. Good luck with your plagiarism reduction in your classes.